So, hello everybody. So thanks for inviting me to show my current research. I'm Bruno Bastien. I'm currently working at the Max Planck for Intelligent Constants in the department of Yann Cousin. And I'm going to show some results of Yang Li and Anya Vegder, which was a master student in the lab. So I'm going to discuss like the recent progress we made on the fishing matrix. So by matrix, I mean matrix like in the movie Matrix. So for people who haven't seen the movie, it's a 1999 American movie where people are living together in a virtual world. So usually, it's quite common to use matrix as a shorthand for virtual reality. So when people say, oh, it's matrix, it means it's virtual reality. So by virtual reality, what we mean is that it's an artificial environment which is experienced with sensory stimuli provided by a computer, and each which one action partially determines what happened in the environment. So what that means is that like, your perceptual environment is going to be immersed in a numerical simulation and it's going to be interactive. And the action you are going to do are going to modify this virtual world. So what you might have in mind is the headset, which are like quite common, like Oculus Rift and this type of stuff. So the first one is from 1968. So what's happened is his headset was just in front of this visual field, and it's going to allow him here to see image in the direct environment, actually. So as you can see, like he's seeing a cube. So it's 1968, so now we are doing that much better. The basis of all this technique of virtual reality is the anamorphosis, which is an illusion based on perspective. So there is this artist called Felice Varini who is painting this structure on the environment. So when you look them from the white place, you are seeing this grid that appears in space. But if you are at a different place, then the perspective is not correct and you can't understand the image anymore. The idea of virtual reality is then to account in real time for the position of the viewer and to modify the the perspective so that the image appears correct for the viewer. So this example from 2007. So here they use like a Wiimote, so it's a Nintendo remote control. And basically, if you look at a screen, what you see is that like the image looks static, and if you move, nothing appears. But at some point, it's going to modify the system so that like the position of the camera is going to be tracked in real time. And the image are going to be changed for account for the position. And so now we can give the illusion that there is like object in the 3D space. So it's important to understand at this point that like this illusion only works for one perspective. So for each user, we need a different system. So now the question is that like we're interested in animals. So the headset is not going to work. But this type of technique can be used for animals. So recently, John Stower, Max Hofbauer, and Andrew Stroh in Vienna started to develop systems for freely moving animals. And here it's a fly. So you have a fly here. Okay, you have like multiple camera tracking the animal. And you have a projection here that is like this virtual environment. So the idea is to give the illusion to the fly. There's a pylon in the middle of the room. So what you see is that like the fly is going to move, the perspective is modified at each point so that to account for the perspective of the fly here. And if you look at all the trajectory, the fly is going to avoid the object. So it is now possible to give the illusion to individual that there is object in their environment, like virtual object. So I'm going to use a more restrictive definition of matrix. In the case here, what I'm going to use is the fact that like, it's an immersive and interactive virtual environment that is shared. Meaning like we're going to have like multiple animals in the same virtual environment and where social interaction can happen. So there are multiple motivations to try to reach this kind of system, but I'm going to give you one that is more like on the theoretical side, let's say. So basically, like, in collective behavior, if you look at the classical model of collective behavior, they are all going to have like, some implicit of distance. Ouais. If you look, by example, the Wilczek model, what you say is that like, the animal is going to interact with its closest neighbor. If you look now, by example, at the Cousin model, you are going to say like in the certain zones, they are going to be repelled, in certain zones, they are going to be aligned, etc., etc. But all these models are going to have like, this type of implicit, like the animal have directly access to the distance of its neighbor. But they don't have directly access to this information. This information needs to be integrated through their perception, in particular through their visual field. So if we have access to a virtual reality system, then the goal is to control and to perturb individually the visual field of each individual. So it's, sorry for that movie. So it goes with like some research, by example, by Ariana from Paken Cuisine Lab, where they started to look the influence of the visual field on the organization of the swarm. But there is really a need. Like, if we want to go further, we need to find a way to get closer to the visual field. So what is the relation between the visual field and the movement? And can it control and perturb the visual field of each individual? Then virtual reality. An important point for us is that like, we want to be able to generate like, social interaction in a virtual environment. So how do we generate social interaction in a virtual environment? So if I just look like the definition of social interaction, social interaction is an interaction between two or more individuals. So fine, but the question now is that like if I have the individual interacting through their virtual representation, do I still get a social interaction? So how can I account for that? So that's what I'm going to discuss mainly here. So the system we have is called the FishVia, developed by Loop Bio. So we have a ball here that you can see here on which we are going to project images. Inside the box, we have like four cameras that's going to track in real time the position of the individual. So by eye counting like for the position at each time, we're going to modify the perspective and we can create an interactive virtual environment and give the illusion of the animal that there is object in the virtual space. So the first thing we need to do before is to try to get a feeling of what is the social interaction between two fish. So here I'm only going to look at zebrafish larvae. So if you put two fish together, so that's the symbol in the real world, but it's just a 3D representation. So what you see is that like they are going to interact together. So one fish is going to follow the other. And they are going to interact more or less in the same plane. Okay, and sometimes this interaction is going to stop, so they are going to live their life, and then they are going to interact again. So that's the basis of the social interaction between two individuals. So all the analysis I'm going to do on this presentation is going to be based on this simple analysis, meaning like I'm going to look at my focal fish, and in the referential of the focal fish, I'm going to look the position of the other fish. Yeah. If I do that multiple times, I can create a density map that is going to tell me where I can find like the other fish. Okay. So if I do that now for my two fish, what I see is that like in the case, in my control case here, where I just have two normal fish, I'm going to have like this map. So it's ever going to be my fish is here, the other fish is ever in front or in the back. Meaning I'm going to create like pair of leader-follower. Like ever the fish is going to be followed and the other one is going to follow it, or it's going to lead. It's going to be followed by the other fish. What we try to do is also we knocked out the lateral line. So the fish have a lateral line on the side that allows them to sense hydrodynamic flow. That is thought a lot to be central to collective behavior in fish. If you knock out like the lateral line, you still get the same pattern. In like the two fish still get like a similar interaction even in absence of perception of the hydrodynamic flow. You have like one that is going to be in front, what is going to be in the back. So in that case, I get like both on the same time graph because currently we can't conserve identity during the analysis. So now what we do is that like we look at the movement of a fish. So that's our zebrafish larvae. You have like this burst and glide movement with like some oscillation during the burst. And we make a virtual representation of the animal. So that's our virtual zebrafish that we're going to put in the virtual world. So now from the point of view of the fish, so that's the projection, so that's the virtual fish, and the real fish is here. So here, the real fish have the illusion that the virtual fish is somewhere in the middle. So here, it's going to follow it on. So that's the first thing. But now what we have is that like, we have multiple systems in the department. We have like five systems. So that's the fish matrix, if you want, like, from the outside. So we can connect like multiple systems together and give the illusion they are in the same virtual environment. Namely, like in one ball, I'm going to have like this real fish looking at this virtual fish, which is in fact controlled by this other real fish and other ball, which is looking at this virtual fish, which is in fact this one. So they're interacting in two different balls, but in the same virtual world. So if I put my two fish together, I'm going to have like this thing. So the two fish here are not in the same ball. Okay? They are together in the same virtual world. But I'm going to see similar dynamics from what we are seeing together. One fish is going to follow the other, and they're interacting more or less at the same plane. And sometimes the interaction like break and come back. So it seems that we're able to create like something that look like a social interaction. More in detail, like if we look like so that's the first fish, that's the second fish. Now the density map is going to be more clear. One fish has the other fish in front, it's going to follow it. And the other fish is going to have the fish in the back. It's going to be the leader in that case. This is really variable, meaning like if we do the experiments multiple times, we create this pair of leader-follower almost all the time. So now if I can put two animals and get, I can also put like four of them. So just to show you what's happened, if you put like four individuals, so each one of them is in a different ball. But they are going, but they are interacting together, and they are going to school in the virtual world. But we can go even further. Like now that we know, like two individuals seem to behave in the same way as in the real world, we can also remove the feedback. We don't need to have like the connection between the two individuals. I can just pre-program a track and see if my fish is still tricked. So here I have like one real fish that is following a virtual fish that's going on track. And what we see is that like this fish is going to follow the virtual fish in a way that seems to mimic the social interaction we are seeing in the real world and in the matrix. But if we're able to do that, now we can like try to map precisely and accurately the parameter space. So for example, what we did is that like, we use this circle here. And we did it for different speed. So that's my virtual fish here. We put it at certain depth so that it can be visible. And then I'm looking what's happening when I change the speed of my virtual fish. So here it's for low speed. So that's the inter-individual distance, the distance between the real fish and the virtual fish. What I see is that like, when the speed is small or comparable to the speed of the real fish, they are going to be close together. And you can see here also like on the depth, they are going to be at the same depth. But as you increase the speed, then this interaction is going to disappear. So this interaction that we see also happen only in cases where the range is similar to the range of the real fish. But now we can also say that maybe they're just following like anything we put in the ball. But we can change the virtual representation. So we had something that was like very realistic, that looked like a fish, that seems to behave like a fish. And so if you look now at the speed of your virtual fish in the range that is like realistic, like for different, and you look at the inter-individual distance, you see like in the case you have a real fish, it's going to be close by most of the time. So it's going to be like less than 7 centimeters. But if you look now what's happening, if you just put a sphere, then you don't have the interaction anymore. So in a way, the interaction is selective. So based on all these criteria, we can more or less determine that there exists like social interaction inside the virtual world. So that means like, in the virtual world, the interaction is independent of the lateral line, so it's independent of like the perception of the dynamic flow. It reproduces the feature of the social interaction in the real world, like leader-follower, distance of interaction. It's similar to an interaction without feedback. So the feedback doesn't seem to be even like a feature necessary for a social interaction. Is observed in a large range of parameters that is realistic. So with that for speed, with that like, for a lot of different parameters. And is also selective on the visual appearance of the virtual representation. And it doesn't work with a sphere. I'm just going to spend like 1 minute on perspective. So where do we go now that we have that? Like, so one part of the problem is try to map like the whole parameter space. We can modify and tune all the parameters we want. So for example, if you use scale, so that's like the proper size of the fish, that's like 10 times the size of the fish, that's like a tiny fish, and we look at the inter-individual distance, we see like we don't have much interaction when the fish is too small, but when it reaches the right size and when it starts to grow again, this distance increases. If I put now my two fish in the matrix and change their size, I'm going to see that like they are going to be close together and I'm going to increase the size. So we have no way to modify directly the interaction between individuals. I can like tune like the relation and the distance at which they want to be together. Another side of the work like we're working on is that like we can modify like the network topology. So by example, I can have like this fish that like sees this one that is seen by this one, but it's seen like some virtual fish and have like some really complex topology and try to see how like information is transferred inside like this complex network topology. I just haven't said. And so the last slide is this one. So that experiment by Liang Li, which is like a postdoc in the lab, who is here at this point. And what he tried to do is that he just put two fish together, two virtual fish, going straight at certain distance. And what he observed is that like, if we look at the position at which the fish is, when this inter-individual distance between the two virtual fish is small, the two fish, the real fish is in the middle. So it seems to make consensus between both fish. But at some distance, it's going to bifurcate and going to choose between one fish or the other. So using this type of tool, we also have a way to try to go like further into the like, decision-making process of the individual. Finally, because I still have 1 minute, one of the goals like, for the future is Simon Gingin, is a field biologist in the lab, make like 2D scan of coral for his experiments. And so one of the goals also is like in the future is to reproduce natural environment and try to do like a field experiment directly in the lab. Thank you.